replacementparts.com. In this video, I'm going to show you how to replace the carburetor assembly on a Ryobi trimmer. The carburetor creates the air-fuel mixture that allows combustion in your trimmer's engine. The carburetor tends to be sensitive to dirt and debris, which can plug it. Also, if you allow fuel to sit in the carburetor for an extended period of time, it'll tend to varnish the inside components of the carburetor, which will also plug them. It is possible to rebuild your carburetor. However, if that's a repair you don't want to do yourself, or if the carburetor is so badly plugged with varnish and corrosion, then this kit will allow you to replace it. Replacing the carburetor is easy to do, and I'm going to show you how. Carburetor assemblies, as well as many other parts, can be found on our website. Let's get started. Before removing any of the fuel lines from the carburetor or the lines from the tank, you'll want to make sure that you drain any gas that might still be in the fuel tank. I'll begin by removing the rear cover. Now remove the two screws that secure the carburetor to the engine. Now I can pull the carburetor away, disconnect the throttle cable, and remove the fuel lines. Now reattach the line that goes to the primer. This is the one next to the adjustments. Now remove the incoming fuel line from the fuel tank. The fuel filter nipple passes through the bottom of the tank, and this makes for a very tight connection. The easiest way to remove this, since we're going to be replacing it anyway, is to just simply cut it off. So first I'll pry the plastic washer away from the fuel line. And now I'll just cut that off flush to the tank. Now use a small screwdriver to push the remainder of the fuel filter through and into the tank. And now I'll tip the trimmer so that the fuel filter falls out of the gas tank. Our carburetor replacement kit includes a new fuel filter with fuel line and a second piece of fuel line. The second piece you actually will no longer need. The older models used to have a short piece of line between the fuel filter and about this point here. The line was then cut, and this fitting was installed to extend the line to the carburetor. But the current kits include a long enough piece of line that this is no longer needed. Now I'll install our new fuel filter and fuel line assembly. There's a couple of things I'm going to do to prepare the line to go into the tank a little easier. First, I'm going to cut a taper on the end of the line, and I want to cut off as little of the line as possible here. Next, I'll take some two-cycle mix oil and just lubricate the line so it'll slide through the hole in the tank a little easier. And now we can install the assembly into the fuel tank. I'll insert the fuel line into the tank and try to snag that tapered end we cut on the line on the hole that the fuel line passes through. Then I can pull it through and work the nipple on the fuel filter into the opening. Now using a fairly large flat tip screwdriver, I'll insert the screwdriver into the fuel tank and place the tip of the screwdriver on the plastic button that's on top of the fuel filter. I'll apply gentle downward force to push the fuel filter into the tank, at the same time pulling on the fuel line on the outside of the tank. The fuel filter line kit includes a small plastic washer. This washer goes over the fuel line and up over the nipple on the underside of the fuel filter, and this just locks the fuel filter in place. Just want to slide it up until it's flush with the underside of the tank. Now insert the fuel line through the hole in the back side of the carburetor plate. I'll go ahead and cut that end square that we tapered earlier, and again I want to cut off as little of the line as possible. And I can reinstall it to the carburetor. Now install the carburetor gasket that's included in the kit. If there's any old gasket material on the carburetor base, you'll want to clean that off first. Now I'll reinstall the throttle cable back onto the carburetor's throttle linkage. And I'll secure the carburetor as well as the choke plate with the screws. As I tighten the upper screw, I want to make sure I have the choke plate lined up as well as the wavy washer so it doesn't get pinched by the screw. And now I'll reinstall the rear cover with the air filter. And that's how easy it is to replace the carburetor assembly on your Ryobi trimmer. If you found this video helpful, be sure to give us a thumbs up and leave a comment.